Yay, it's a Christmas update. Fantastic, we're gonna check the update notes right away. Speaking of update notes, take a look at this update history. They have been working a lot lately. Really, really impressive. Good job. And today, yes, today it is Christmas. So we have a Port Jackson reskin Christmas update. Now Port Jackson is also very much bigger or larger, so, and that means that there's a lot more things to go around and take a look at. So, and we also have fishery skins in Port Jackson. That's gonna be interesting. And as we can see in the blurry background, we have snow particles now in Port Jackson. This looks fantastic already, and I haven't really seen it yet. and so this one is also good. This has been annoying when you do the hunting, so you can enable automatic camera recentering on boat, so it's gonna be off by default. That's like how it was in Fishing Simulator. Very, very good. So we have a new mythic rod, limited mythic rod. Worth to mention, all these rods are limited, meaning that once this event is over, you're not gonna be able to get them again. So you have the nightmare rod, which is a mythical one. We have the northern lights rod, which is the legendary rod, and you have a north pole rod, which is an epic rod. And then they also brought back an old rod, that's the Christmas lights rod. I had it in the video from last year, but we're gonna take a look at it anyway in this video as well. And then we have backpacks. We have apparently three backpacks. So you have the new limited Christmas stocking backpack, you have the seasonal Santa gift bag, that one we got last year. We're gonna take a look at it again. And we have a new lantern backpack, and this one is gonna be super interesting to see. I'm really looking forward to it. So we have also one new spear, that's a limited Candycane spear, and we have a new limited Santa sleigh boat. Also brought back the gingerbread boat, that was also from last year's video, but we will bring it out to see what it looks like. Fantastic. And there is also a lot of other fixes being added into this update, which is also great. They keep fixing every single thing right now, it feels like, and it's really, really exciting to see. This game is getting better and better every day. So let's go inside, and here we are. Fantastic. I'm already saying that it is fantastic, and I've just seen a few presents on the ground and a little bit of snow. So yes, we have snow everywhere. We have snowmen, we have candy canes, we have gifts, half buried gifts, gingerbread figures, we have Christmas lights and ornaments, we have ice on the roof, we have snow, we have, what do we have? Yeah, we have candy canes everywhere. The balloon looks awesome. Oh yeah, and we have a Christmas tree. We need to try to climb it, obviously. Yeah, looks good. Yeah, this works perfect. I want to get to the top, you know. There we go. If we reach the top, then it's approved. Yes, we are at the top. This is a perfect tree. I love it. We're gonna go, where shall we start? So we should maybe start with the rods and then go to the backpacks and end with the boats. So I'll be right back, and I will go and fix the rods. So first of all, this is what it looks like in the chest. We have the nightmare rod, which is the mythical one. And as you might have noticed, the percent has dropped a little bit because now it's split among one more mythical rod. So it was 0.12% before, now it's 0.11%. So everything is a little bit harder because there's a bigger chance that you might get a different mythic rod. But you have the nightmare rod, you have the northern lights rod, looks like this, and then we have, let's scroll a little bit, we have the north pole rod. And the one that is from last year, the Christmas lights rod. I'm gonna open one chest just for fun. Yep. Regardless, we have them. We're gonna take a look at them. And yes, we can also, while I have the inventory open, I can show you this new skin on the fish in Port Jackson. It only goes for Port Jackson. So you have a trout. I'm gonna check it out. Let's see. Here we have it. With a Christmas hat. It's a very strange looking trout, but it is what it is. It's Christmas, right? So you have a stingray in an ice block. Wow. Nice. Really cool. Not used to see them like that though. And then we have the butterfly fish. Pretty solid piece of ice, I must say. It's really freezing. Really freezing out there. Alright. And we can check the bluefin tuna as well. Let's see. Yeah. There we go. Awesome. Is the swordfish is normal, I think. Whoa. Okay. So I fell through the world. That's weird. Alright. I'm underneath Port Jackson now, am I? Yes, I am. Okay. Yeah, so yeah, so this is a weird place to do a recording, yes, so it's a little bit dark, and we have a hat. We do have a hat. Fantastic. We can't really see it though. We need a brighter place. Maybe I should just reset. Yeah, let's do that. That was a failure. New attempt. No, what's happening? Again. Alright, so the swordfish has some issues, I believe. Let's reset. Oh, man. How can we show the swordfish? I need to be up in a tree. Yep, I need to climb a tree. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna show you a swordfish out in the open, not underneath some island. So we're gonna climb up on a tree. This tree will be just fine. We will equip the swordfish. No, it doesn't work. Ah, man. Okay, so this was a little bit unplanned. Can we find a bright place so we can take a look at the fish? This might be the place. Yes, here we can see it. Excellent. So a little hat, no ice block or anything. But yeah, don't equip the swordfish. It it will not do you any good, all right? Nice. All right, so I guess I have to reset again so we can get back on surface. And here we are. Where were we? Yeah, we were supposed to take a look at the rods. Oh my god. All right, so let's go check them out. We have them right here. So we're gonna start with last year's Christmas lights rod. 5% reeling speed, 10% rarity chance. Looks like this. I think it's very good looking, actually. One of my favorites from last Christmas. Very colorful. I like this red orb up in the top, or the red ornament up in the top. Looks great on the ground, but here is a little bit of an issue. I think at least it's an issue. Not a serious one, but still. What happens in the water is that it just becomes black. You can't really see it. It disappears. So going from something that looks really, really nice into something that doesn't show at all is a little bit disappointing. But it might be something that they will fix. Might be just something temporarily. They are prioritizing. Whoa! What was that? Whoa, I had to try that again. Let's see. No, I couldn't do it again. I don't really know what happened, but I loved it. Okay, so we're gonna move on to the next one. The Northern Lights Rod. That's the legendary. Should we go for the epic one first, maybe? Where is it? Yeah, we go for the epic. The North Pole. So that's 15% reeling speed. So quite nice, simple stats on an epic rod. Focusing only on reeling speed. Quite cool, actually. So gonna see how it looks. A little bit dark, but it's brighter when I stand next to a light. Let's see, is it the sign that we're gonna fish with now? Or no, it's not. Oh, it's a part of the sign. Okay, interesting. So you have a full sign saying North Pole, and when you throw it, you throw away the NO. All right, nice. Always like new rods. Moving on to the legendary rod, Northern Lights rod. So it looks like this. We have all the stats actually. We have 5% hook speed, 5% rarity chance, 5% strength, 5% reeling speed. And it has this white egg-like shape. And you have some white, I don't know, some kind of light or something around it. Gonna equip it. No. That's not white. That's very dark though. Okay. It's very nice glow on this, I don't know what to call it, but the thing that goes around it. But this centerpiece, that looks like, I don't know, piece of coal or something. And the line is not really aligning properly. So this, it looks like a cat toy. So you can run around with it and hopefully you can get some cats following you. But yeah, we're gonna see how it behaves also in the water, obviously. So let's go to the water. Let's see. You can still see a big chunk of black, well, I would say coal. But yeah, big bobber, no glow. I hope they fix this to being white as this picture, because this picture looks much better. Regardless, it's a nice looking model. I really like this glow effect around it. It's perfect, good one, except for this dark piece in the middle. Very nice. And now is when things becomes more interesting. So this is the new mythical rod, the nightmare rod. Here it is. And this was a huge surprise to me. Take a look at this number. Okay, we start from the beginning. Not gonna jump into the best parts right away. 4% hook speed, 37% rarity chance, 4% strength, 5% reeling speed. 37% rarity chance. This beats the crown rod when it comes to rarity. So this is number one right now. This is totally unexpected and totally amazing. And this is a great opportunity for everyone to get a really, really good rod when it comes to the rarity chance. So just go try to get this one, because this is a surprise. Really, really surprise. Very exciting. We're gonna take a look at it, of course. And here it is. Nice red ball up here in the top. I do expect that it will behave like all the other bobbers in the dark water, so it will not be as exciting when I throw it into the water. But let's do it like this, so we can really have a good look at it. Yeah, this is cool. This is really cool. Really like it. Very good looking. So on the ground, yeah, looks bright, looks red, looks good. And we're gonna see what happens. Yes, it's like all the other rods currently. The glow effect just disappear in this water, becomes pretty dark and boring. But I hope they will do something about that in the future, because yeah, some of the rods has become a little bit more boring because of this. But I think we're gonna do the backpacks first and end with the boat. I think that's a better idea. So we're gonna go for the backpacks and also check out the new spear. That's gonna be both interesting and most likely expensive. So we're gonna equip the new rod because it's awesome. And we're gonna go to Finn's supplies. Good old Finn. Here we have him, and it's nicely decorated on the inside here as well. Gifts everywhere, and yeah, he wants all my money and gems so he can take them. And then we start with a new spear. Here we have it, limited, new. It's a nice feature actually. So now it's very easy to see which one is the new one, and also that it is limited. Very nice. Oh, it costs 20,000 gems. RIP, but it is what it is. I must have it though. So we have a damage of 750, pretty high. And the specialty is that it freezes the target for 2 seconds. So it's pretty much, is it similar to, yeah, the Chill Fury, which is less damage, of course, but I believe it has the same kind of behavior with this freeze target. Yeah, this one is limited. It's a must-have, of course, and 20,000 gems. Goodbye. All right, so we have it now equipped. Let's see. Wow. All right. Interesting. Really interesting. Will it freeze the shark, or will it just one-shot the shark? Oh, it's good to... Oh, I like that the old camera behavior is back. Let's see. So one hit and it kills the shark. So that is maybe... Well, we don't really see the freeze effect at this stage. So this freeze effect will only occur, of course, if you don't kill it. And the only sharks that you can't one-shot is the oversized shark. So this spear could be useful maybe on neon orcas. That might be the best place to use it, because then you have like 4 or 5 orcas maybe, and it will freeze the orca. And we are gonna go to the backpacks. This is gonna be a long episode. Oh yes, and there is also a new code, and I believe it's actually the first code in Fishing Frontier. So we're gonna try it out. I have no idea what's gonna happen, but it should be this code. We got ourselves 300 gems. That's perfect. Fantastic. I love it. We finally have a working gem code again. And here we are again. Pin supplies. This time we go for backpacks. So this was from last year. It was massive. I remember it when I got it. 600 in backpack space. Oh, totally awesome. Yes, and it looked like this. Really good looking and great for this Christmas theme. Now, on the other hand, we have 2 more new backpacks. So we have this new limited one, and I see more gems gonna disappear shortly. So it has 630 in space. So if you didn't get this sand pail from the summer, which has 650. This is still a good expansion up to 630. And yes, we are of course gonna get this one since it's limited. So it's another 4,300 gems. Bye bye. Yeah, I think this new one looks even better than last year's, because it has so much more details with gifts and teddy bear and candy cane. Yep. Really cool. But I am actually more curious when it comes to this other backpack, the one that is most likely, hopefully, cheaper. This one, the lantern, perfect for lighting up your fishing trip. Will this glow? And if that's the case, 55,000, that's a steal. That's a really good price. And even if you use something like this and it says backpack space 90 and you have larger backpacks, you can always just switch to a smaller backpack and you will keep the maximum space from the largest. So keep that in mind. So we're gonna buy this one, obviously. That's a must. Yes, it seems good. It looks good already. Will it? Yeah, I need to go to a dark area, obviously. So it's nighttime. Perfect. Take a look at this. This is awesome. It's a backpack that will light up the surrounding area. This is like the torch, except that the torch costs 500 gems and this is just coins. I think I will use this backpack all the time, regardless what season it is, because I always run around with the torch. Will they stack? I think it actually might stack, so it becomes even brighter now. Perfect. This is a great combination. Torch and the lantern. Amazing. Yeah, so this is much easier now to climb because you see the surface much better together with the backpack and the torch. So this is well spent money. 55,000 coins. And apparently it didn't record properly when I was purchasing this new Santa sleigh, and it had a price of 15,000 gems. And I maximized everything. As you can see, the first one cost coins. Second one was also coins. And this reeling speed which is unique. It's a specialty that hasn't been on a boat before. So this is the first time you can get additional reeling speed on a boat. Made it very, very special. I maximized it and it cost around 2000 gems. I would say well spent gems because it's unique. We're gonna go and take a look at this right away because it's the one that is new. Let's see. And it was also fast, so that is also something that's really, really interesting. So this is what it looks like. The speed is great, the specialty is great, the extra reeling speed, it really shows that you have more speed into the rod. So this is a really, really good boat actually, especially if you want to catch a lot of fish. Really exciting. I was surprised that it was this good. Last year's boat, the Gingerbread Boat, is so much bigger and clumsier. We're gonna take a look at that one as well, but this is the only thing that annoys me a little bit. So you sit so close that you get this message all the time, can't really get rid of it. So if you press E, hold down E, then it disappears, but as soon as you release it, it comes back. So yeah, that's a little bit of annoyance. But the boat in general is great. Really, really great. You're gonna see the last year's boat as well. That one is big, wide, huge and clumsy. But it's very good looking. I just think that the scale of that boat is a little bit off. But this one gave you instant value. Meaning that if you fish something, you will get money directly on top of the normal fish that you can also sell. And take a look at this size. It's big. It's really, really big. But still, it's good looking. As I changed a little bit in the customization, so you can get neon colors there instead. So once you catch the fish, so let's catch a bluefin tuna. See what we get from it. So we got additional 28 coins because of the boat. All right, so I think we're done with that one. You can see more about that boat in my old Christmas video from last year. I think my character is a little bit broken right now. But that was pretty much everything for this episode. I think we covered everything. So we had the rods in the beginning. We did go through the backpacks. We had the spear and we had the new boat. So that was quite a lot actually. So yes. And we got a new quest. Perfect. Well, in any case, that was all I had for you today. If you do have any questions and comments about this, please put them below. Like this video if you would like to see more content from Fishing Frontier and other Roblox games. Please subscribe and yes, have a nice day.